So there's a paper that looks at sodium consumption and mortality, right? And this is
There's been a lot of research on that.
Well, I'm thinking of one. But, I think you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, O'Donnell? O'Donnell in the New England Journal of Medicine from 2014. If you go on our blog, we have a posting on sodium intake and adrenal why adrenal fatigue is not a real medical issue. And this is discussed in that paper as we've referenced there. Sodium is obviously a very controversial area, and people have almost, let's say, very intense convictions, including dispute among mainstream scientists. So this is not a resolved area as yet. But in the study published in the New England Journal by this group, it's an international research consortium studying lifestyle factors and health outcomes in a couple hundred thousand people in 17 different countries.
Sure.
It's a massive study called the PURE, P-U-R-E, that's the acronym, study. And they, rather than asking people how much salt did you eat yesterday, they actually got a urine sample from people, from over 100,000 people, and then looked at sodium excretion at that time point, and then their subsequent, assuming that the day before they'd eaten whatever their usual salt intake would be. Inaccurate if you were dealing with a few people, but when you have 100,000 people, it gives you a good measure of range of sodium intake. And then they looked at health outcomes for 4 years afterwards. And the total mortality and coronary disease, that is heart attack risk for people, was a U-shaped curve. And the bottom of that curve, where the risk was lowest, was between 4 and 5 grams of sodium, not salt, 4 and 5 grams of sodium intake per day. When people went down to the value where the current U.S. recommendations are, at 2.3 grams per day, there was actually a measurable increase in risk. Mm-hmm. And under 2.3 grams, again, these are people in multiple cultures in many different countries. But consistently, there's a rise when you restrict sodium severely. And as one increases sodium intake past 6 or 7 grams a day, then the risk also begins to go up. Now, there are some regions and some cultures where people eat a lot more sodium, and there is evidence that that can be dangerous. For instance, among fishing villages in Japan, where the sodium intake may be in the 10 to 15 gram per day range, that can be associated with increased risk of stroke and even heart disease. So again, this is not a blanket permission to eat vast amounts of salt. But particularly when somebody is on a ketogenic diet, which enhances the kidney's ability to clear extra sodium, it appears that the beneficial range for people who don't have significant heart or kidney, already have significant heart or kidney disease, the beneficial range is in the 4 to 5 gram per day of sodium intake range.
Yeah, I think an important takeaway from this is that it's always in context. It's always for an individual person. You have to consider all of the different things that they have going on. And we can't give a blanket across the board kind of recommendation. But
if somebody has fluid retention or hypertension,
right,
high blood pressure,
much more careful
requiring diuretic therapy, we get people onto the ketogenic diet and get them keto adapted. And typically we withdraw the diuretic medication. Then we then begin to gently add back the sodium to optimize their circulatory reserve, their well-being, and their function.
Yeah.
So again, this has to be individualized, and as Dr. McKenzie says, you can't give blanket recommendations, and we're not doing so here.